My name is Patrycja and today I'm going to talk to you about my Florida field course. So I'm actually here right now. I'm at the Vesta Field Station in Southwest Florida. Today is our last day and we've been here for just over a week, and honestly it's been an amazing experience, and I'm going to show you some clips of what we've been up to and what we've been doing on a day-to-day basis. The whole point of this field course is to gain as much intel about all the species and all the wildlife and the ecology of the area. So on certain days we've been going out to places like Corkscrew, which are nature reserves, and we've been taking notes of all the organisms, and then later we're going to be assessed on that being written up in our field notes. In general, the field courses are an optional module in my zoology course.
It's really early in the morning, 5 a.m. This is us at the airport. This is loads of the food on the plane. That's the journey that you can see right there. And the views over America were amazing. So our first full day at the Vesta Field Station started off pretty chill. We just explored and then we did our grocery trip because we did have to make our own food, and that also made the trip quite cheaper. And then we had a look around the Vesta Station, so I did a little tour. That was the wet lab and the classroom where we did some work later on. Those are the canoes which we could take out, and the docks by the mangroves. And this is a little quick tour of our room. So there was 6 of us sharing. That's our fridge. There was 2 beds in the kitchen and 2 bunk beds in there. We all shared the bathroom. We didn't have much of an issue with that because there were some spare bathrooms outside anyway. And we even had like laundry so we can reuse our clothes, especially after doing some muddy work. And yeah, that was our view. It was really nice. And then for that afternoon, we went to Barefoot Beach.
So we're walking around Barefoot Beach. And in some of the shrubbery, and we're basically taking pictures and noting down what species we see to put into our field notebooks, and we're probably just gonna be doing some quick notes and in the afternoon going over and looking them up and adding some extra information onto that.
And we saw some really cool stuff. We saw a snake and these sanderlings, which are my favorite bird because they run back and forth from the tides. And they're super sweet, and they actually eat these little bivalve shells, which I've got a video of now, which are like, if you look carefully, they're going into the sand. We also saw a vulture and this little raccoon. On our second day, we went to Corkscrew, and we started off the day by getting a snake handed round to us, which was really nice. And then we were taken over around by the volunteers there, who knew so much. We were scribbling information for the whole day, and we saw some little baby alligators, which was really cute. And then later that afternoon, we saw the mummy alligator when we went back to visit. Saw lots of amazing birds like this anhinga, which was whacking its fish and then basking in the sun later. So loads of lizards, this ibis, a snake, and these cute otters, which were, you could hear them chirping in the background. And this poisonous snake, it was called a cotton something as well as this amazing hawk. There was just so much wildlife there. It was the best day, honestly. I would really recommend if you do go there. We saw lots of vegetation as well, and it was just a really lovely day to be out. And then in the evening when we came back, we got a chance to take out the canoes before it got dark. So here's us just outside the Vesta Station. We didn't go out too far. Day 3, we took part of a beach clean, which was a sudden addition to our trip because we were just randomly invited, but there were many other volunteers, and it was held at the Vesta Field Station, and it was actually a really fun day. They took us on the boats and we all went to different mangrove sections, and we did some picking up of fishing nets because people usually throw those near mangroves to try and get the little fish that hide in there. And then we were treated to some pizzas as a thank you, and we actually even had a camera crew and ended up on the news, which was quite amazing. That was quite a cool experience. We got a talk from Mike as well, who's in charge, and then we got out on the canoes again. Just couldn't get enough of them. It was so fun, and because of the morning, we then had a more keener eye looking out for the plastic, so we actually picked up some more plastic, and then we went to Bonita Beach. And we did some obligatory cringy photos as a team, but it was just so much fun, really. This last picture is my favorite, it's so cute. Day five, we went to Florida Gulf Coast University. So we were greeted by Wynn and shown around. We were given this snake, which was actually so beautiful. And then we were given this talk and we went on a little swamp walk where we were shown these leaves. And Wynn was so passionate about what he does. It was really, really cool to see. We saw this little baby alligator behind us, stayed away. And then we carried on with the swamp walk. And during the swamp walk, we basically put down little fish traps. And then when we came back to collect them, these are what we found. There was even a snake in one, but it escaped before we could catch it. So that was really nice. And for the rest of the time, we went to the shop. And the shop was the size of Audi, and that was just their merchandise shop, which was insane. And we went over some of the biodiversity from the other day and some conditions that we had to look at as well, and this beautiful osprey we heard calling. In the morning we did our presentations and then we headed off to Lover's Key, where we actually got to see some manatees. It was the highlight of the trip. They were really shy, so we didn't see much, just their little snouts and tails coming up, but it was so great. We spent about half an hour just watching them circle around and graze. It was just such a lovely experience. We didn't have high hopes of seeing them, so that's the photos that I managed to take. That's the most we could see. And then we spent the rest of the time doing our field notebook. So we saw lots of lizards, we saw this snake, and just lots of wildlife. This tiny little hermit crab that was so cute. Amazing wildlife again. We just took notes of everything we could, took pictures of anything cool we could see, which was most of it, which is going to be hard writing up. And another highlight were these gopher tortoises. We were supposed to see them at Barefoot Beach, but it was too cold. But then we managed to see them here at Lover's Key, and they were so sweet. And they were actually really, really confident. They came right up to us. We even got to take some cool pictures with them. Our last proper day was Ding Darling. So the first part of the day we spent in the main section looking at all the information, learning about the wildlife that we're going to see. That's one of their crocodiles that they used to have. And then we set off on the Indigo Trail. We saw lots of plants and lots of birds and invertebrates and insects, some insane looking spiders. And then towards the end we got to the main bit where we saw loads of birds, especially white pelicans, so that was really exciting, as well as this really cute snowy egret, which I kept taking pictures of. So we spent the rest of that afternoon having a swim. We did try to look for sand dollars, but unfortunately we did not see any. We were digging in the sand for a while. So we packed up the night before and then did our final packing in the morning. We're all very, very sad to leave. And then we set off to the airport to fly back home.
Thank you so much for watching. If you liked it, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the Bangor University YouTube channel to see more videos about student life. And if you have any questions, don't forget to leave it all down in the comments. And I hope you sign up to go on the Florida field course, because it was an amazing experience and it honestly, it changed my life.